like Harvey's ball, but Hunter decided to take charge. Spate, Field, Dearden with a clear sight of goal! Oh, so unlucky! So terribly unlucky! A beautiful effort by Billy Dearden, hit the foot of the upright. Magnificently taken chance. Nowlead with Yorath. Jordan! Well, Sheffield United have come closest to a goal. That was a great effort, pushed through by Field to Dearden, who took it first time against the upright. But now it's Leeds on the attack. A lot of men there. Clark! Oh, Clark! Back. Bad luck for Sheffield. A mixture of mishaps. The ball was deflected by a defender. Jim Brown, the goalkeeper, was totally stranded, and all Alan Clark had to do to get his sixth goal of the season was touch it in the net. And Hunter's gone down. Hunter went down with a tackle after the ball. Now, this could produce a conference with the linesman, and if the linesman saw that incident, somebody on the Sheffield United side could be in serious trouble. It's Keith Eddy who's going into the book. He followed through and hit Hunter. So two bookings within a minute for Sheffield United. First, Eddie Cahoon for dissent, then Keith Eddy for a late tackle. Now Badger also. Well, this is rather sad because the game began at a cracking pace with no real ill feeling. Eddie Cahoon began it by arguing. He may have felt he was justified in doing so, but he was booked. And now Eddie has left Hunter on the ground. Badger has also gone into the book, and suddenly it's all turned sour. In fact, it isn't Hunter, it looks like Joe Jordan who went down. Yes, it is Jordan who was tumbled. So Joe Jordan gets up again, and as a result of that incident, two more Sheffield United players have been booked. Free kick to Leeds United. The game now boiling up, unfortunately, because the opening 20 minutes or so is full of so much good things. But now Jordan's going in again. Hemsley, McQueen, off the line by Franks. And there are more bodies in the penalty area. Hemsley's down. It certainly looks as if members of each side have singled each other out. That's the only interpretation one can put upon this sequence of events. Ted Hemsley up. The throw taken, Lorimer to Giles. Back for Curry, good move, Curry! Oh, he hit Reedy on the backside, on the line. He may have given a penalty. I think he's saying he hit Reedy on the arm and it's a penalty. He's given a penalty. He said that Reedy kept it out by his arm. I thought it hit him in the small of the back. The referee says no, don't argue, it is a penalty to Sheffield United. Bewildered but Mr. Yates and Keith Eddie comes up, and if he lands this, it's his fourth penalty of the season. If Keith Eddie puts this away, it's his fourth penalty, and he becomes Sheffield United's leading scorer. He hits the post! Well, I never! Paul Reaney will say that's poetic justice.
McQueen. Spade.
Good shot! Oh, how unlucky can you get? How unlucky can Sheffield United be? A beautiful shot by Mickey Spade. Hit the angle with Harvey Beaton.
Frank's under pressure, and Clark can get it. Clark has got it. It's over the line. What a weird goal.
What a fantastic mix-up. Really, did you ever see anything so weird and wonderful in your life? Eddie Cahoon's back pass. Colin Frank's, Jim Brown got mixed up. Alan Clark's shot deflected, and Jim Brown unable to stop it from crawling over the line.
Giles. Jordan going into penalty area, goes down, another one. It's another penalty. Mr. Yates rules it straight away. Joe Jordan, and this... Cahoon falling about laughing, can't believe it. Cahoon sees it as a sick joke. I know that Sheffield United manager Ken Furphy and one or two players saw the FC Zurich game, saw the circumstances of Leeds United's penalty in that game, and were watching for that this afternoon, but Mr. Yates had no doubt, and this could be four. Four! Up for Jonas.
Good goal! Good goal and a beautiful goal. A really fine goal. What a wonderful goal. Chipped up by Johnny Giles. Terry Jonas knew exactly where he was going and where the ball was going to be.
Jonas. Leeds now have strung together nearly 40 passes and only once. Now, Mr. Yates has blown his whistle and brought it to an end. He's coming to have a word with Terry Yorath, who's hobbling about. Now, Yorath presumably accused of either ungentlemanly conduct or talking too much. A free kick has been awarded to Sheffield United. Up for Dearden. Yes! A goal! The bizarre events of this match continue. A most remarkable free kick when Leeds had possession and no Sheffield United player was anywhere near them. Awarded against Terry Yorath, and out of it comes a goal for Billy Dearden, which Sheffield United deserve, but which really adds another chapter to a most incredible sequence of events in this game.